John chapter 8 and verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
So the Bible says we're going to eventually find out the truth, and the truth will set us free out of these conditions that we're in today, out of the mental conditions that we're in today. The sister just came up and asked, is Baptist and Christianity in the Bible? Is Christianity and Baptist in the Bible? Yeah. No, it's not in the Bible. Give me Colossians 2 verse 8. Yeah. That is not in the Bible. The Bible is dealing with one specific people. But Christians mean follower of Christ. But ain't nobody following Christ. Everybody following the traditions of this world.
Right.
That's why we are confused today. That's why we're in the lower states that we are in today. But we are here to show you who you are according to the Bible. Read that.
Colossians chapter 2 and verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ.
So sister over there who asked about the Baptist in the Christianity, the Bible said, beware the people spoil us with philosophies and vain deceit. After the tradition of men, what men have deceived us to follow in them? The so-called Caucasian race. They have deceived us. They put us in low-income housing, and we still have to pay them. We still have to pay them. The problem is, we going through this because we not keeping God's commandments. Do you hear that, young brother? We trying to show you that you a king according to this Bible. The problem is, we not keeping the commandments in this Bible. That's why we not reaping the benefits of being a king. Come here, let me talk to you for a second. Ain't gonna take long, bro. We out here to talk to you. Hey, sister, come here over there in the pink shirt. Come over here and talk to me. We come out here to speak with y'all. We come out here to show our people the solution to our problems. Because we don't know the solution. We just walk around every day confused. Let me ask you this, young brother. What color is Christ? What color have you been taught Christ is?
White.
What about you, bro? What color is Christ?
White.
You say white too? Sister in the pink shirt, what color is Christ?
White?
Okay, now y'all answer this question for me. Who told y'all Christ was white? Did y'all ever pick up the Bible and read it? Or somebody taught y'all that over time? Taught to you, right? It been taught to you. But what we come here to show you that have been lied to. Christ is not a white man. Christ is a black man that look like you, young brother. And I'm going to show you that. Just stand there 1 second. Read that.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14.
I want to start at 1 and 1.
Revelation 1 and 1.
Uh-huh.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
So this is the revelation. The revelation meaning the revealing of Christ. Meaning we showing you what color Christ is according to the Bible. So when you leave here, you won't be confused on what color Christ is anymore. You hear me, sis? You hear me, sis, in the pink shirt? We're going to show you that Christ is a black man according to the Holy Bible that we probably got in all these apartments out here. Watch this. Read that.
Verse 14.
Uh-huh.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So he said his heads and his hairs were white like wool, meaning the texture of wool. See how you rubbing the head? That's wool, bro. Which one of these got woolly texture hair, bro? Which one of them? This one right here, right? So this one strike against this white boy right here. Okay, keep reading. Now, what we trying to show them right now, these young men, it go to show them why our communities are destroyed, because these young brothers don't know the color of Christ. So they grow up looking at one another like another nigga, not knowing they royalty, not knowing they come from a royal bloodline.
Right.
That's what we come to show y'all today. Watch this, read.
As white as snow.
So he had fully white hair, or fully gray, what we'll call it today, right? Watch this, read.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
So his eyes was a flame of fire. Which one do you got? Eyes like fire, bro. Which one of them? You see it? Come look, sis. Come look. You see this? Come up close, sis. She ain't got to stand back there. We out here for you. I promise I'm your brother. You see this? The Bible said Christ had red eyes. And the reason they were, why do you think Christ's eyes was red, sis?
Give me Genesis 49.
What you say, bro? What you say, sis? Oh, okay. I don't know. Okay, well, why do you think his eyes was red, sis? Watch this. I'm going to show you. Let me ask you this. What was Christ's first miracle? Do you know? You don't watch this.
Genesis chapter 49 and verse 12. His eyes shall be red with wine,
and his teeth white with milk.
So the Bible says his eyes should be red with wine because Christ drunk wine. His first miracle, he turned water to wine. He turned water, his first miracle, he turned water to wine, right? So he said his eyes shall be red with wine. You know when you drink the white around your eyes, what color they turn? They turn red. You see the young boy know that. Read. We proving that Christ is a black man according to the Bible. Read it.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
So if we look, if you take off your shoes right here, sis, what color are your feet? Brown. Your whole body brown too, also, right? So they looked down at Christ's feet and they said his feet was as a color of fine brass. Brass is a pigment of brown, right? Bro, you with me? Watch this.
As if they burned in a furnace.
As if it was burnt in a furnace. If you burn anything, what color it turns? If you burn it.
Why do he have to tell y'all this?
Black. Black. So what color is Christ according to the Bible? A black man.
Yes,
we have
right.
been deceived of following this. But you got to understand, sis, did Christ warn us about the switchery of rule of his identity? Give me Matthew 24. Christ let us know that they were going to try to trick us out and change into his image. Watch this. Well, we're trying to prove to you that you're an Israelite, that you're from the same lineage of Christ. Yes, you've been growing. Okay, you answer this. How many churches you've been to in your life? In your whole life? Four churches. Now, how many churches in Pensacola? Just give me an estimate. 100. Okay, 150 churches. How is our communities? Tore down. So have Christianity or the churches been giving us a solution to our problem? You answer that.
Let's look around.
Just look around. For one, I asked these young brothers what color is Christ when they first walked up. Every single one of them said white. That go to show, and the Bible says he what color? So the Bible says he's black. This go to show we haven't been deceived because we've been following this.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? Watch this. It was a warning about that, read.
Matthew chapter 24 and verse 4. Uh-huh. And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ.
Who's saying they Christ? Do you ever see a black man say, I'm Christ? Who's saying that? What man on earth calling themselves Christ? Look, they got a whole bunch of pictures.
Right.
If you Google Christ, what color he gonna pop up? White. Showing that we have been deceived.
Right.
Give me 1 Corinthians, 11 and 4. Give me that. We showing you, says that we have been deceived. But the thing is, the Most High is waking us up now. He's waking us up now. What do we got to do? Hold on, before we go down, let me ask you this. What is your nationality according to the Bible? What is your nationality? What nation do you descend from?
Indians.
What'd you say, bro?
Indians.
Okay, come look on this sign right here. You say a native, an Indian, right?
Yes, sir.
What do God call you? Look on that sign. Hold on, we talking about nation.
Nation.
Nation. What nation do you descend from?
America. Native.
The name, Gad. So you from? So he say native. According to the Bible, the natives are from the tribe of Gad.
Yeah.
I'm an American, so-called American black. I'm from the tribe of Judah.
Yeah.
So we trying to show our people the nation of Israel have 12 tribes, and we come from them tribes, and we know that because of the prophecies in the book of Deuteronomy. What you got, Deuteronomy? Now hold that. Go to Deuteronomy. I'm gonna show her that you descend from this nation of Israel. I'm gonna show it to you. And I'm going to try to make it quick as possible because you say you got to go to work. Give me Deuteronomy 1 and 1. Watch this, sis. We are here to show our people that we are the greatest people on earth. That we come over here and talk to me, sis. I come out here for you, too. Come stand in front of me because we're trying to show you my sister. So me loving my sister, come in front of me. Come in front of here. Me loving you as my sister. When I let my sister continue to walk in darkness, when I know the way up out of darkness.
How about that?
Won't I come out here too with my sisters and brothers that to show them the solution to the problem? That's love. Ain't nobody gonna come out here and post up like we do. But that's what we gonna do. Watch this. I'm gonna prove to you and these young men that they from the greatest nation on earth. Okay, but all the stand up that you know, and I gotta ask you something. Read this.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1.
Read.
These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
So these be the words which Moses spake unto who? Who you say he spoke
Israel.
To? Israel, you hear that, bro? Give me Deuteronomy 28. Sis, listen to me while you're over there at that car. You about to go. I had this answer for you. Give me 5 more minutes before you leave. Just give me 5 more minutes.
You ain't gotta go nowhere.
5 more minutes. Give me Deuteronomy 28 to 15. Watch this. These be the words that Moses spoke to who again, bro? Israel. Y'all heard that. You heard that too, sis. Did it say any other nation? What did it say? Israel. Watch this.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
Read.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So the Most High God told the Israelites, if y'all don't keep my commandments, all these curses is going to come upon y'all and overtake y'all. Is a curse a good or a bad thing?
Bad.
It's a bad thing, right? We all would agree. You would agree too, right?
Definitely.
Read this, key read.
And thou shalt not, I'm sorry, verse 16. Curse shalt thou be in the city,
uh-huh.
And curse shalt thou be in the field.
Now the Most High told the Israelites, curse shall y'all be in the cities. In the city of Pensacola, are the blacks cursed or blessed?
What y'all think y'all live? Curse or
bless? I'm talking. They see young kids. I'm asking you.
No, I'm cursed.
I'm asking you.
I know we curse.
You see that? We know that. We know that. That's why we gotta teach these to the younger, so they won't be confused. So they already know what they're dealing with as they growing up. So Moses told the Israelites, "Curse shall I be in the city of Pensacola. Curse shall I be in the city of Pensacola." Now we fill up the county jails to the point. They building a bigger county jail. Guess who they gonna put in that county jail?
All y'all and us.
Everybody out here that's going against they laws.
Right.
They gonna stuff you in the jail and they giving you 10 and 15 years. Okay, he said, curse shall I be in the field. City, and curse shall I be in the field. Who says over there? Who was cursed in the plantation field?
Nuh-uh, they don't get 15.
Huh? Cursed in the plantation field.
Okay, who was cursed in the plantation? You answer that. She said she.
African American.
Okay, the so-called African American.
Indians.
Indians
as well.
And the Indians always well. We were cursed in the cotton field.
Easy to tell, but it's just, I'm
in the tobacco field. That was us out there working for free.
We was cursed.
But guess what? Moses told us that was going to happen for breaking his commandments. Give me Deuteronomy 28 and 16. I know you got to go. This going to give it to you. This going to sell it off. Because this only happened to one nation of people. This didn't happen to all the people on the earth. This curse right here. Watch this.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 68.
Really?
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with
silver. Hold on. So the Bible said, and the Lord shall bring thee into, give me Exodus 20. The Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. Hold on. Don't go nowhere. Egypt is anonymous for bondage. Hold on. The Bible, the King James Bible.
Okay.
So he said, the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. If you know the story of Moses and Pharaoh when he said, let my people go. They was in Egypt, right? What conditions was they in Egypt?
They were slaves.
They were slaves. You see that, sis? They were slaves in Egypt. He said, and the Lord shall what?
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
And the Lord shall bring you into slavery again.
That's when the Africans American.
Okay, how we got into slavery? How did we get to this side of the earth?
We got kidnapped.
On what was the transportation? Say, bro, walking
the
down the street.
The boat.
How did we get on this side of the earth?
We were sold by a boat.
By a boat. Do the Bible say that?
No.
Say that?
No.
You say no.
No.
Do the Bible say that we was gonna get sold on ships?
Oh yeah, you know. Yeah, he said that.
Watch this. Watch this. The Bible. Moses told the Israelites that was gonna happen to them. Read it from the top again. Watch this.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
With what?
With ships.
The Lord shall bring us into Egypt, which means bondage. Hold on, let me prove that. Because give me the Exodus 20. I'm going to prove that Egypt means bondage, which means slavery. I got to prove it. Young brother, make sure you come back. I ain't finished talking to you. Read that.
Exodus chapter 20 and verse 2.
Read.
I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt,
uh-huh.
Out of the house of bondage.
So he said, out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of what, sis? Bondage. What bondage mean? What's another word for bondage? Not bun together. Bondage. Bondage. Meaning slavery. Slavery. You bond, you a slave.
Same
when you yes. So he said, so he said, you should go back to Deuteronomy 28 and 6 day. Hold on, sis. I got to finish this verse before you go. Read it.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
It's bondage again.
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
Okay. How you say we got on the side of the world?
Man,
the ships. Who that happened to? Us. Proving that we are who?
Slaves.
Who, what nation?
That we are the people from Jesus, from the Lord.
We are the children of Israel. This Bible belongs to us and us only.
Right.
We don't know that. Give me Amos. Let me show you that, because when I said that, you was like, what? Because we have been, like I said, we have been following Christianity all your life.
Because the white people wanted you to know that.
Okay, we have been following Christianity all our life. They forbidden us to read. They forbidden us to write, right?
Correct.
And then they told us that the Bible belongs to everybody, right?
Correct.
But do the Bible says it belongs to all nations?
That's how you get his code.
No.
Have you ever read that? So what do we get God love everybody from then? Where do we get that from?
She said out the Bible.
Out the Bible? Okay, read it.
Amos chapter 3 and verse 1.
Read.
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you.
Hold on, sis, come right here. Come right here and talk to you, sis. You ain't got to stand back there. We ain't going to talk to you. I'm going to prove to you that what you just said was taught to you. It's not biblical. Read that. Read it again.
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel.
Oh,
O children of Israel.
Read.
Against the whole family.
Against the all 12 tribes.
Right. Read.
Which are brought up from the land of Egypt.
Who was in Egypt in bondage?
Israel.
The Israelites. Read.
Saying.
Saying.
You only.
What? What did he say?
You only.
Say it again.
You only.
Read.
Have I known of all the families of the earth.
What did he just say?
Now, I ain't never known that.
What did he just say? What did he say, sis? Don't choke up now. I need you to stay with me. What did he just say?
He said we're his only family.
That's
you
right.
You heard that, sis.
That's right.
Read it from the top again.
You only.
From the top.
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel.
Read.
Against the whole family.
Read.
Which are brought up from the land of Egypt.
Read.
Saying.
Saying.
You only have I known of all the families of the earth.
He said, you only, children of Israel. Have I known for all the families of the earth?
Give him a fire. Give him a
now
fire.
What? Watch this.
Therefore,
just because I only know you, all children of Israel,
I will.
Read it, come on.
I will punish you for all your iniquities.
He said, just because I know only you, therefore I will punish you and you only for your sins.
Right.
Because he done told you the commandments.
Okay, now you know the commandments. You see that? He said, you only have I known for all the families of the earth. Therefore I will punish you for all your sins.
Right.
Did he say I'm going to punish the white man? What's his name? Esau in the Bible. Did he say I'm going to punish Moab? Which is the Chinese.
Right.
Who he said he going to punish?
Bring it up.
The Israelites. Okay, now what one of the curses he put on the Israelites? They are going to slavery how? On slave ships. Was the white man chained outside of us? Was the white man chained up when we was a slave? Was the Chinese man chained us when we was a slave? Go give me Joel 2 and 27. I'm going to prove to you, sis, that this book is only for us.
Right.
We have been deceived. Then give me Deuteronomy 7 and 8 after that. I'm going to show you that we have been deceived. But it's a new day. The prophets are back on earth, and we're coming to show you your nationality.
That's right.
We're coming to show you that you're the greatest people on earth, sis. All we have to do is come back to God's commandments.
Right.
That's one of the commandments. Come over here, sis. Don't go nowhere. I need to talk to you. You stay right there. Your medicine ain't gonna go. You know you already took it.
I already watch took it. My medicine.
Joel chapter 2 and verse 27.
Listen to this.
And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel.
He said, you shall know I'm in the midst of who?
Israel.
What did he say? You see that, young sister? What did he say? Israel, young brother. Yeah. Read.
And that I am the Lord your God.
And I'm the Lord who God?
Yeah.
Israel. You hear that? He said, I'm the Lord your God. You hear that, sis? I'm in the midst of who? What did he say? Israel, read it from the top again so this sister right here can make sure she hears.
And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel,
uh-huh.
And that I am the Lord your God,
uh-huh.
And none else.
What did he just say? What did he just say, sis? What did he say? And what did he say? What else he say after
that? Y'all got it, none else.
You heard that, I'm your God and none else.
Right.
Meaning nobody else.
Right.
So what we get God love everybody. Where we get that from?
What you read from right now?
What was that? Read from the top again.
Joel chapter 2 and verse 27. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Lord your God, and none else.
And none else.
Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.